Namaste, myself Mr. Birajdar Bala Saheb, Assistant Professor, Department of Humanities and Sciences, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video lecture, we will discuss Laplace Transform using the property effect of division by t. Learning outcome. At the end of this session, students will be able to apply the property effect of division by t to find Laplace transform of given function. Let us start with the property effect of division by t. It states that if Laplace transform of f of t equal to f of s, then Laplace transform of f of t upon t is equal to integration with limit s to infinity f of s ds. Now, working rule to solve the problems. When given function is of the type f of t upon t, we have to follow the following steps. Step 1. First, find Laplace transform of numerator function f of t and denote it by f of s. Step 2. Using effect of division by t property, we write Laplace transform of f of t upon t equal to integration with limit s to infinity of f of s into ds. In this result, substitute the value of f of t in the left side and its Laplace transform f of s in the right hand side. Step 3. Integrate right hand side integration with respect to s between the limit s to infinity. We get required answer. Now consider examples. Example 1. Find the Laplace transform of 1 minus e raised to minus t upon t. Here, in the numerator function 1 minus e raised to minus t is denoted by f of t. And now we have to find its Laplace transform. Therefore, Laplace transform of f of t, which is equal to Laplace transform of 1 minus e raised to minus t, which is equal to Laplace transform of 1 minus Laplace transform of e raised to minus t. This is using linear property. Therefore, Laplace transform of f of t equal to Laplace transform of 1 minus e raised to minus t, which is equal to, now Laplace transform of 1 is 1 by s, minus Laplace transform of e raised to minus t is 1 upon s plus 1. This is we can write using the formula Laplace transform of e raised to minus at equal to 1 upon s plus a. So, this Laplace transform of f of t answer is denoted by f of s. Now, by property of effect of division by t, that is Laplace of f of t upon t equal to integration with the limit s to infinity f of s ds. Now, in this result, in the left hand side, replace f of t by 1 minus e raised to minus t, and in the right hand side, f of s by 1 upon s minus 1 upon s plus 1. Therefore, Laplace transform of 1 minus e raised to minus t upon t equal to integration with limit s to infinity of 1 upon s minus 1 upon s plus 1 into ds, which is equal to in bracket. Now separate the integration for each term, we get integration of 1 upon s into ds minus integration of 1 upon s plus 1 into ds, bracket close, limit s to infinity, which is equal to in bracket integration of 1 by s with respect to s is log s minus integration of 1 upon s plus 1 with respect to s is log of s plus 1, bracket close, with limit s to infinity. Now using logarithm property, log a minus log b equal to log of a by b, we can write this right hand side as log of s upon s plus 1, bracket close, with limit s to infinity, which is equal to in bracket log of s upon, from denominator we can take s common, in bracket 1 plus 1 by s, and bracket close, limit s to infinity, which is equal to, now s gets cancelled, in bracket log of 1 upon 1 plus 1 by s, with limit s to infinity. Now we have to substitute the limits of s. When we put s equal to upper limit infinity and using the result 1 by infinity equal to 0, we get log of 1 minus, when s equal to lower limit s, we get log of 1 upon 1 plus 1 by s, which is equal to log 1 is 0 minus. Now log of 1 upon 1 plus 1 by s can be simplified as log of s upon s plus 1. Therefore, Laplace transform of 1 minus e raised to minus t upon t is equal to, we can write log of s plus 1 upon s. This is the required answer to the question. Now pause the video for a while and write the answer to the question. Question is, find Laplace transform of sin t upon t. Come back. I hope you have written answer to this question. Now here I will going to give the solution. Question is, find the Laplace transform of sin t upon t. Here numerator function sin t is denoted by f of t and its Laplace transform is equal to 1 upon s square plus 1 and denote it by f of s. Again by property, that is effect of division by t, stated as Laplace of f of t upon t equal to integration with limit s to infinity f of s ds. By this property, we can write Laplace of sin t upon t equal to integration with limit s to infinity of 1 upon s square plus 1 into ds. Now integration of 1 upon s square plus 1 with respect to s is tan inverse of s with limit s to infinity. Now substitute the limits. We get, when s is upper limit infinity, tan inverse of infinity minus, when s equal to lower limit s, we get tan inverse of s. Therefore, Laplace transform of sin t upon t is equal to, now tan inverse of infinity is pi by 2 minus tan inverse of s, which is equal to pi by 2 minus tan inverse of s is equal to cot inverse of s. So this is the identity from inverse trigonometric function. This is the required answer to the given question. Now let us consider another example. Find the Laplace transform of sin square t upon t. Here numerator function f of t equal to sin square t. Now we have to find Laplace transform of sin square t. But it is not in standard form. First we have to simplify it as 1 minus cos 2t upon t from trigonometric function formula. Now by taking Laplace transform on both the side, we get Laplace transform of f of t, which is equal to Laplace transform of sin square t, which is equal to, now in the right hand side, 1 by 2 is a constant coefficient, right first outside the bracket, and in bracket, Laplace transform of 1 minus cos 2t, we can separate into two terms, that is Laplace transform of 1 minus Laplace transform of cos of 2t using linear property. Therefore, Laplace transform of sin square t equal to 1 by 2 into bracket. Now, Laplace transform of 1 is 1 upon s minus Laplace transform of cos of 2t is s upon s square plus 2 square, but 2 square you can write as a 4 and bracket close. So, this result is denoted by f of s. Now, by effect of division by t, Laplace of f of t upon t is equal to integration with limit s to infinity f of s ds. Therefore, by this property, we can write Laplace transform of sin square t upon t is equal to, now in the right hand side, f of s we have to substitute, and coefficient 1 by 2 I can write outside the integration, and into integration with the limit s to infinity in bracket 1 by s minus s upon s square plus 4 bracket close into ds, which is equal to 1 by 2 as it is in bracket, separate the integration for each term, first term integration of 1 by s into ds minus, for second term we can adjust 2 in numerator and denominator to get in standard form, therefore 1 by 2 into integration of 2s upon s square plus 4 into ds bracket close with limit s to infinity, which is equal to 1 by 2 as it is in bracket. Integration of 1 by s is log s minus 1 by 2 as it is into integration of 2s upon s square plus 4 with respect to s is log of s square plus 4, bracket close, with limit s to infinity, which is equal to, now from the bracket we can take 1 by 2 is outside, so that 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 is 1 by 4 into bracket 2 into log s minus log of s square plus 4, bracket close, with limit s to infinity, which is equal to 1 by 4 as it is. And by property of logarithm, 2 log s, you can write log s square, and minus log of s square plus 4, you can write log of s square upon s square plus 4, and bracket close, with limit s to infinity, which is equal to 1 by 4 as it is, in bracket log s square upon, from denominator s square is taken common, and in bracket 1 plus 4 upon s square, bracket close, and curly bracket close, with limit s to infinity. Now s square cancel, therefore Laplace transform of sin square t upon t equal to 1 by 4 into bracket log of 1 upon 1 plus 4 upon s square with limit s to infinity. Now we have to substitute the limits of s, which is equal to 1 by 4 in bracket. When we put s equal to upper limit infinity and using the result 4 upon infinity tends to 0, we get log 1 minus, when s equal to lower limit s, we get log of 1 upon 1 plus 4 upon s square, which is equal to 1 by 4 in bracket. Log 1 0 minus log of 1 upon 1 plus 4 upon s square can be written as log of s square upon s square plus 4, which is equal to 1 by 4 in bracket minus log of s square upon s square plus 4, bracket close, which is equal to 1 by 4 log of s square plus 4 upon s square. So this is the required answer to the given example. Now to prepare this video lecture, I refer these two books as references. Thank you.